Hello students, so in this programming practice we will try to implement the for loop and we will try to play with different kinds of ways in which we can implement this for loop. Okay, so let's create a new file. Okay, let's include iostream header file using namespace std, then init main. Let us first try to write the program which I explained to you in the lecture, the very first program in which we printed slide 10 times. Okay. For int I equal to 1 semicolon I less than equal to 10 I plus plus C out slide and then return 0. It is taking some time. Okay, so it is printing slide 10 times. If you modify this program, I is initialized to 10 here, I greater than equal to 1, I minus minus, then what will be the output? The output will still be the same, because we are running it 10 times. It does not matter whether we are running it from 1 to 10 or from 10 to 1, because we are not using the loop variable inside the for loop. We are just printing slide. Okay. So again we got the same output. Now instead of printing slide, let us print the value of I. Okay. So it is printing the values of I from 10 to 1 because we are decrementing the value of I. Now I am changing it, I equal to 1, I less than equal to 10, I plus plus. So now I am incrementing it. Now it is printing the values of I from 1 to 10. Okay. And we can modify this program. I have declared I outside the loop. Okay. Will it make any difference? No, there is no difference. It has given us the same output as before. But what if I also initialize the value of I outside this loop instead of inside the loop? Here what I have done, I have declared and initialized the loop variable I outside the for loop. Okay, but inside the parentheses of the for loop, I have left the portion where I initialized the loop control variable as blank. But you have to put a semicolon, okay? Otherwise, it will give an error, okay? Now let's try to run it. Again, it is giving us the same output, I from 1 to 10. Okay. Now let us remove the increment expression from here and put it inside this for loop. Now for loop has two statements, so we have to put them in curly braces. So should we put increment statement before the cout statement or after the cout statement? It turns out that when we unfolded the for loop, the expression was executed first and then the increment or decrement occurred. So increment or decrement will happen after the execution of the statement. Okay. So will it give us the same output? Yes. Okay. Now let us try to remove this semicolon and see what will happen. Now it is giving us error. Okay. So it is compulsory to write the two semicolons inside the parenthesis. And if I remove this condition also, then what will happen? Let us try to do this also. Now there is nothing in the for loop and I have removed the condition. What will happen now? Now it has resulted in an infinite loop. Okay, so the loop without the condition is an infinite loop. Okay.